Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Good to see you. So, in my consideration for today's lecture regarding the real and the unreal, it caused me to look inside myself and see, all right, how do I deal with the real and the unreal? And what do I consider to be real? And what do I consider to be unreal? You, I consider to be very unreal. But that's no exception. At times I consider myself to be very unreal too. So basically what I'm talking about here in that respect is behavior. Our behavior, of course, is a portrayal of our inner awareness. And all of this is making a reflection on how it is that we relate one to another, how we relate to ourselves. So the world about us is changing. Oh my goodness me, it is changing. What used to be when I was a kid isn't what is right now. And that's a reflection on my awareness, but it also is a reflection on things that have changed and are continuing to change. If you focus all of your attention out there, and your attention is affected by the media, then of course you're going to have a view on life that is going to be filled with struggle and strife. It's going to be filled with judgment and criticism, and that translates into very unreal. But if you take all of your considerations away from what is, then you look and see that where is the ability to actually distinguish things? If you give away your judgment and you have nothing to replace it, how are you going to actually engage in what's good and not so good? And if you don't, then it seems like standards are going to disintegrate. Right now, there's a lot of pressure that we accept everyone as they are, regardless of their behavior. And if you've ever tried that approach with raising children, you know it has some really interesting results. Kids just go along as if they can do anything and everything they want to. Of course, they eventually outgrow it. I mean, here we are living examples, right? And then we look in the work world. Workers can become sloppy and unmotivated without some comparison of what good work is and what is not of that same standard. So we're already seeing the signs of this approach being taken so far as the deterioration that comes from the absence of making distinctions for fear of offending or leaving anyone out. You might could say, well, where do we go and what do? Well, where we go is within. And what do is we start taking an assessment of who we are and how we perceive ourselves to be. Because you see, if we just relate to life through judgment, then we are aiming that at ourselves and we're also aiming it at everyone else. And that implies a power differential. All kinds of judgment does. Judgment feeds the ego's deception of being better or worse. And it assumes the power and right to determine what's good and what's bad. It is unconscious. Notice how it is that when you react to someone else's behavior or your own, how it is an unconscious is almost like the knee jerk. Judgment has a sense of finality. It's like a sentence being passed. Like when I look at you and I see some of the things you do and I say, my God, what a jerk. That's total judgment on my part. That's a projection of my ego's own sense of self on you, whether it's appropriate or not. And bringing that word appropriate to the foreground When we go within and we start seeing, okay, I need to move away from judgment, but I need to replace it with something else so that there's a semblance of order and balance inside of me, we go to discernment. And the discernment is a little more personal. And it's definitely more of a conscious approach. Discernment allows us to distinguish what is appropriate and what is inappropriate. You might could say that it's a judgment, but it's not the same as judgment in that it is not a sentence being passed. There's no finality there. It's like bringing all of us together from a place of understanding both ourselves and others, and to see how it is that we often impose hurt, suffering on ourselves as well as on others, and what we need to do to help bring that to a place of better comprehension and more peaceful interacting is to have compassion. Now, having compassion often requires that we find out what compassion actually is. What does it mean? If you've never attempted to be compassionate toward yourself, but you've always been hard on yourself, then there's some growth opportunity there for you. And you look to discernment to help you with that growth opportunity. Because discernment will give you a clarity. But you have to sit down with it. You have to be patient with yourself. You have to go to that place of allowing a true perception to come forward where judgment doesn't affect you. Because judgment merely serves the illusions of our minds. I'm talking about your mind, my mind, the one that we live in all the time, regardless of whether anyone else is around or not. If we believe ourselves to be better or worse than others, then we're judging. And we will never experience true inner peace. So when I'm talking about the real and the unreal, I'm talking about what is going to make a difference for you with you and you with others, so that you can learn how to quiet the mind instead of allowing it to dictate policy. It's funny that mind that I'm referencing seems to be used by quite a few of me. My ego will use it sometimes. I will use it as access sometimes to my higher self. I can actually go into my mind and find places of connection to others through compassion. I can also find myself slipping very quickly into judgment, same mind. So this really is learning to be present with yourself so that in your presence and with your own presence, you can actually bring forth discernment to distinguish between what is appropriate and inappropriate. Ultimately, in order to quiet the mind, we do need to discern between the real and the unreal. And if you're operating unconsciously, then in all likelihood, you're believing the unreal to be very real, and the real to be unreal. You've got to be kidding me. Compassion? You've got to be out of your mind. Yes, exactly. So that we get to that place of having an operating sense of perspective that allows us to move in this life with a growing sense of ease and a growing sense of self-power, self-mastery, that's based upon discernment instead of judgment. Thank you for your attention.
For more information about the Metaphysical Church of Enlightenment or the Rodin Foundation, please go to our website at www.rodin.org. If you have been inspired by the revelations shared in these podcasts, please donate to the Rodin Foundation's ongoing efforts to help others help themselves at www.rodin.org/donate.